You're fired.
What?
Sammy.
How hard can it be to find the perfect wife?
Well, maybe you should look a little closer to home.
So you're actually going to propose?
Mate, she's the kind of woman I could cheat on for the rest of my life.
We have to stop them!
What are you doing here?
There's something I have to tell you.
Jesus!
If either of you show your face at Borkman's Law again, I will quite literally murder you to death.
Is that me or you?
I just don't know anymore.
Spirit's broken, when hope is hard to find, when everyone's on board the life train, but you got left behind, when Lady Luck has
and
left you, when the chips are down,
dream,
when you
swing
hit rock bottom, it's just me.
There's a light on the porch, and it's me with the torch, shining bright and true, for me and you, and we'll see each other through, and I'll stand by you, cause that's what friends should do. So in the absence of a more attractive offer, it's just me and you.
Buzz buzz, 6 o'clock, my alarm goes off. Time to start my day. I'm a brand new Jay.
Boom, boom, boom.
Brush, brush, pearly whites. I'll take my wrongs and make them right today. Come on and say it with me as the sun shines down on the endless possibilities that this day can offer us. We give our thanks and praise it as.
Oh, oh God! Oh, oh, what happened?
Stop my toe!
Oh! Don't look at it.
What?
Don't look at
oh!
it. Oh, he looked at
I
it.
I looked at it.
You shouldn't have looked at
you
it.
You shouldn't have told me.
Look don't
at
look. It's horrible.
Oh!
What's it called again?
Paracetamol.
It really works.
Mm.
Anyway, as I was saying, once Mr. Borkman sees my unfair dismissal claim, he'll have no choice but to give me my job back.
Well, I see your unfair dismissal claim and I raise you a folder of my own.
What's in this?
Unpaid fines, credit card debt, false identities.
Theophanus Smiginski.
That got me out of Croatia.
So you're finally going to take responsibility for your past mistakes?
Nah, I'm going to burn them.
Why?
Check the answering machine.
Randy, it's your ex-wife, Victoria Vincent. I got your message. Midday at Tratatosco's works for me.
Let me get this straight. Your ex-wife, Victoria Vincent, has finally agreed to meet you for lunch, and you think you'll win her back if you destroy all evidence of your past failures?
Chicks dig a clean slate.
Well, ordinarily, I'd pick apart that flimsy argument, but today belongs to the dreamers. So while you're winning back your wife, I'll be winning back my job.
Hooray! Go on. Have a look.
No, I'm good.
Go on. You know you want to. Take a peek.
No, I'm fine, thanks.
Look at him. Look at him. No? Oh, it's a shame. Very impressive.
So then I said, you're fired, you skinny little dead shit, and if you ever show your face in my office again, I'll...
Give him his job back.
Ladies, give us a moment. Your average call girl can hold her breath underwater for about 30 seconds. That's precisely how much time you have to tell me what the hell you're doing in my office.
I'll let these documents speak for themselves.
Hmm, very interesting. You know, you might actually have a case here.
I'm glad you think so, Mr. Borkman.
Well, this is the most clear-cut case of fraud I've ever seen.
Fraud?
Trying to get your job back by shouting your best mate, eh? I didn't think you had it in you.
No, no, that's Randy's folder.
I'd love to bring down the goggle-eyed, home-wrecking, grape-faced prick. Staple it shut and call it Exhibit J.
I can't prosecute my best friend.
You will if you want your job back.
Moral dilemma, moral dilemma, moral dilemma.
choice. Inside my head I hear a voice. The future is unclear. My heart goes boom, boom, choose your friend. But that could be the end of my career.
Moral dilemma.
A fork in the road ahead I see. Mr. Borkman offers me an opportunity. My brain goes squelch, squelch, take the job. Do I dib or do I dob? It's a moral dilemma. Which path do I choose?
Moral dilemma.
Either way I'm gonna lose.
Moral dilemma.
The clock goes tick-tock. I need a little time. I'll let you know by 5 p.m.
I'm finally making good. I'm gonna be the man I should have been. I'm winning back my wife today. I'm setting fire to the past, and nothing's gonna stand in my
I stand in Randy's way.
Moral dilemma.
I have the final say.
Moral dilemma.
I could have my day in court and win a case and earn my place in legal history, but it wouldn't be me. So there's no dilemma in the end, and the moral is I choose my friend.
This friendship is officially over.
What?
Where's my folder?
I left it at the office.
Well, go and get it back or you can find yourself a new housemate.
Oh, what are you going to do, Randy? Not pay rent somewhere else?
Oh, well, anywhere would be better than this shithole.
You take that back.
Oh, I only moved in here because it's 2 blocks from the home of my ex-wife, Victoria Vincent.
But...
And now my master plan is reaching its explosive conclusion. First, I get the girl. Then, I light the match. Then... sky high.
What are you saying?
No, I don't have time to explain. If you want answers, look in my room.
Borkman.
Mr. Borkman, I've decided not to prosecute Randy for fraud.
I knew you didn't have the balls.
I am, however, willing to prosecute him for terrorism.
You little beauty. Where's Crystal? Crystal? Oh, this is how we lost Denise.
What is that?
Oh, it's a chia seed power shake. It really gives me an edge.
You've got a dead hamster strapped to your head.
Oh, no. My hair grew back.
Randy, do you remember how you proposed to me?
In a hot air balloon.
In the basket of a hot air balloon.
Yeah.
On the ground.
Well...
In a shed.
You still said yes.
Well, I've grown up since then. And it's time you did too.
Look, I know I'm not perfect.
No shit.
But I just need you to give me one more chance.
Oh, you've got to be kidding.
No, I just have to show you something.
I've seen it before.
It's not my dick. Just trust me. Please. You won't regret this, Victoria Vincent. I'm one of the good guys now.
Get on the ground!
Huh? Oh! Ow! What the fuck?
Put your hands behind your head!
What's going on?
Get back!
No.
He's a dangerous man!
Ow! Victoria! Vincent! My ex-wife!
May I see the dessert menu? Thank you.
Well, she knew the risks. Hooroo! Now, Sammy, photocopier, fax machine, microfiche, whatever you need, it's yours.
Thank you, Mr. Borkman.
Mate, if you win this case, I'll triple your salary and give you your old office back.
And if I lose? I'll get to work. Wednesday?
Sammy?
Wednesday?
Sammy! I never gave up hope.
And I never gave up. Office fire warden. What were you thinking? Look at this, you got naked flames, no ventilation. What's this? What's this polyurethane resin? This stuff goes up in seconds. Look, highly flammable. Highly flammable. I should better chuck that in the dunny. But go, go.
I'm Victoria Vincent. Deal with it. It's been 1 month since his dramatic arrest, and tomorrow Randy, internationally known as the Terror Man, finally has his day in court. Leading the prosecution will be his best friend and housemate, Sammy J, who joins us now live in the studio. Good evening, Mr. J.
Good evening, Randy's ex-wife, Victoria Vincent. You're looking lovely as always.
Son of a bitch.
Mr. J, you've lived with the defendant for some time now. Surely this case presents something of a moral dilemma.
Not in the slightest. He made his bed. Well, actually, he didn't. Never lifted a finger around the house.
Tell me about it.
Let me out of here!
So, exactly how confident are you of a conviction?
I've got a very strong case. Wait till you hear my opening question.
Are you a terrorist?
No.
Oh. Sorry, Your Honour, that wasn't the answer I was hoping for.
Boo! General heckling!
Sorry, I'm really not sure where to go from here.
Evidence is usually a reliable place to start.
Evidence. Yes. Gas cylinders? Blueprints? Map of the city with tall buildings circled? Care to explain these, sugar tits?
I was building a hot air balloon.
You've had 4 weeks to prepare your defence, and that's the best you can come up with.
It's true. The cylinders are propane and the buildings are circled so I could avoid bumping into them.
And what about the bomb?
Turn it on its side.
Randy, you can turn a bomb on its side, but it's always going to look like a hot air balloon.
I was building it so I could propose to my ex-wife, Victoria Vincent. Properly this time.
Strong defence with a romantic subplot. I like it.
But he's the Terror Man.
You've had 4 weeks to prepare your case and that's the best you could come up with?
Ooh, smackdown!
Your Honour, if it please the court, I would like to present Exhibit J.
What twist?
This folder is a damning dossier of deceit, dishonesty and dodgy dealings. Isn't that right, Randy? Or should I call you Theophanus Maginsky?
Objection!
Overruled.
Isn't the judge meant to do that?
Shut up!
Oh, feisty.
My friends, this man might not seem like a terrorist, but delve a little deeper and you'll find a soul so devoid of decency that if he hasn't already committed an act of terrorism, it's only a matter of time before he does. I rest my face.
Nice.
Wow. Anyone else want to leap to this poor bastard's defense? No love interest or ex-wife up the back? Victoria Vincent's thumb, I now pronounce you guilty. I sentence you to 5 years...
Double it!
10 years imprisonment with an on-parole period of suck my balls!
No! Jimmy! Jimmy!
Jimmy!
In all the time you've worked here, you've been nothing but an embarrassing drain on this firm's resources. And today, none of that changed.
But Mr. Borkman, I won the case.
Oh, I know you did. I was talking to Michael. You've got 10 minutes to clean out your office, dipshit. Sammy J's back in business.
Huzzah!
You were brilliant today.
All in a J's work. I've got another one. Another J, another dollar.
I don't understand.
I'll explain later.
Do you want to explain it to me in the hot tub?
I'm not allowed in the hot tub.
You are now.
So what do you say?
Sounds nice.
Sexual tension, sexual tension, sexual tension, sexual tension, sexual tension.
Now, you're not going to like this, but it's time for me to make you my bitch.
Oh, God.
Checkmate.
Oh, come on!
You know the rules?
No. No.
Mend my trousers.
Zips come undone there. I could probably just hand stitch that.
So how does it feel?
Pretty great. Won a case, got my job back, and now I'm in the bloody hot tub.
All you need now is a girlfriend.
Unlikely. I've always thought it'd be nice to have a girlfriend, but no one's ever shown the slightest bit of interest in me. Well, Bethany in grade six, I thought, did have a crush on me for one semester.
I love you, Sammy J.
You kept that a secret? This was Randy's favourite show. These are Randy's underpants. These are Randy's pubes. Didn't have to do this.
It's our 3-day anniversary. Of course I did, Pookie.
When was this taken?
2 years ago. I thought we could put it up here.
No! Randy put that there.
I am sick of this. Every day, Randy used to do this, Randy used to say that. If you love Randy so much, why'd you put him in prison? No, no, shh. It's just you and me now, my skinny little bitch. Together forever. So get over it. Love you.
Dear Wednesday, by the time you read this, I will be gone. P.S. This was Randy's notepad.
Bullshit!
Righto, fellas. If you're entertainment this week, we've got a singer-songwriter who just today volunteered to do a recital for you blokes. So shut up. Welcome to stage, Theophanous McGinsky.
Yay.
Is that?
Well,
Now we all make mistakes in this big old life of ours, and sometimes we do things we know are wrong. And I betrayed my friend, but I'm here to break him out, so I'm telling him in code via this song.
Now listen up, you piece of shit. You can't just write a country hit and think I'll suddenly forget that you're a prick. I prefer to shove this glass right up your double-crossing ass, so if you've got a plan, you better tell me quick.
Well, there's a car out front and the engine is still running, so on my signal, get ready to flee.
I'm listening.
And if we move real fast, you can grab that warden's gun and start a riot with me on the count of three. One, two, three.
Give me the goddamn keys! So what's the plan?
I don't have one.
What?
I just assumed we'd be dead by now.
Oh, come on!
Still got you out.
Head for home.
What?
Just trust me.
I mean, I've heard of a slow news day, but this is like a snail on smack. What's my lead story?
The inexplicable rise in popularity of ham and cheese focaccias.
Ugh, kill me now.
All units to Ricketts Lane. The Terror Man has escaped.
Only good thing that bald prick's ever done for me. The courageous police have their guns drawn, ready to recapture this vile, cheating, spiteful, selfish, lying, impotent scum bucket.
Side, look.
Any faster?
Oh, sure. I'll just turn down the gravity, shall I?
I need to be snarky.
We need to lose some weight.
What's in this bag?
A packet of crisps and some lubricant.
Wow.
Of course, questions do need to be asked as to whether the police have gone too far.
These up.
Isn't your use of firearms in this context highly irresponsible?
All our officers are expertly trained to avoid the possibility of weapons falling into the wrong hands.
Oh, sweet! There go the sandbags!
Thanks, Wednesday! Love you!
Dramatic scenes here at Ricketts Lane as two fugitives make their daring escape. And a nation is left to wonder, was the Terror Man actually telling the truth?
I think she's giving you the rude finger.
She's dead to me.
So where are we heading?
Wherever the wind takes us.
Is that you or me?
I just don't know anymore.
Thank you.
continued to be continued to be continued. No? Did I misjudge that?
Just me and you.